No, no, it's all right. Off you go. One rule for one for another.
I might have had a little blast at the umpire, verbally.
When it happened, it did look very, very ugly and unbecoming of a leader.
I'd done what I thought was the right thing to do.
Said the spirit of cricket had been violated would be an understatement.
We had about 9 bad decisions in the previous game, and they were pretty awful decisions.
You know, some of them were just saying, right, let's pack our bags and go home.
He wanted to call me a cheat, and unfortunately, we know the rest.
The 1987 tour to Pakistan will not be remembered for the cricket, but more for an incident involving an English captain and a Pakistani umpire. The seeds of discontent were sown earlier in the series, during the first test in Lahore. England felt wronged by several decisions at the hands of a different umpire, Shakoor Khan. Chris Broad refused to leave the field when given out caught behind. He had to be ushered off by Graham Gooch. Then Gooch himself had reason to be disgruntled, before captain Mike Gatting got a hasty LBW decision in the second innings.
The lads know in their own mind it really wasn't down to a great deal of bad batting, it was just something beyond our control.
And so today, 2 of the Faisalabad test. A different umpire, Shakoor Rana, had already had words with Gatting about fielding positions.
It happened just before tea time. Neil Foster, Sally Malik was in at the time, and they were, I think, about 2 down or something, and it was just before tea time, and Fozzie, who was playing with Sally down at Essex, decided that, yeah, let me have the last over for tea. I'm going to bowl and bounce a third ball, so tell square leg just to meander down to the deep square leg third ball. So that's what I did. So there was no moving, but the player obviously went back third ball, and Fozzie bowled a bouncer, and Salim went to hook it, and he did. Fortunately for Salim, it dropped short of the guy down on the boundary, and so he was distressed because he was smiling first up because Fozzie had bowled him a bouncer and he knew where square leg was, and he hit it and he knew it had gone over square leg, and so he was smiling at Fozzie. Then he turned around and looked at the bloke over there and his face changed halfway up the wicket.
Salim explains this to Shakoor Rana, and Shakoor Rana, the umpire, takes offence. He doesn't think this is fair play.
So he then went and I had a chat with Shakoor Rana, who came down to me and said, you know, you mustn't move fielders while the bowler's running in. Well, obviously I hadn't, because the fielder had gone back there in the first place. And I said, well, look, it's up to the batsman at the other end there to actually notice if a guy's gone back. It's not for me to tell the batsman. So that was where it started.
The test continued without incident until the penultimate over of day 2.
Sally Malik was still in. They were about 5 or 6 down by this time, and not for very many either. And there was a new batsman in at the other end, and I wanted to keep Salim down this end.
Eddie Hemmings had 2 balls to bowl at Sally Malik, who was played at Essex. Everybody knew him. He knew us. Eddie was trying to get 2 balls in to him, so there'd be 2 dot balls, so I could bowl the last over of the day to the night watchman. Hopefully, good chance of getting him out.
I tell Sally Malik that I'm moving, bringing all the fielders in. So David Capel was at deep square leg, there was somebody out at cow corner, so they all came in to save the one, basically. So I'd told Sally. Anyway, David Capel came charging in from deep square leg, and he got too close. So all I did was, and Eddie Hemmings, I think it was bowling, he runs in sort of miles and miles, I just sort of went like that to David and say, no, on the one. Now, I'd already told Sally, so all of a sudden, you know, Shakoor Rana comes in, bowler's running in, you're moving fielders again, you're cheating.
There's some sort of a discussion there. The umpire's signalling dead ball.
And I said, look, no, I'm not cheating. I've actually told Sally Malik that I'm moving the field. So instead of asking Sally about whether he'd moved the field or not, or whether I'd told him, he did, and he wanted to call me a cheat. I might have had a little blast at the umpire, verbally, but, you know, I'd actually done what I was asked to do, which was inform the batsman, which I did.
When it happened, it did look very, very ugly and unbecoming of a leader, because England have produced such great captains, you know, good sportsmen, and captain has got to be dignified in his actions. And I thought, you know, it was a little undignified for an English captain.
The next morning, day 3, England returned to take the field, but no umpires appeared.
And the following day, we went back to the ground, and of course we were obviously in the field still, We went to take the field. There was no umpires. We understood they weren't coming out. The Pakistan batsman didn't come out, but we took the field to start the game. And then it was obvious they weren't coming out. We stood around for 25 minutes, half an hour or so, and then came off.
The umpire concerned has refused to go out on the field until he has an apology from the captain in writing, which he's very willing to give, provided that the umpire also apologises for calling him a cheat.
If he comes and apologises in writing from me, then we can start the game.
And even when we went down the following day into the changing rooms to actually discuss this with all the management, and Salim came in and said, yes, Mike told me, you know, that he was moving the fielder, so I have no problem. I was about to shake hands with shakoor rana, and then something was said by somebody in the corner about letting the whole Pakistan nation down if you apologise to gatting.
We understand that, I think the umpires wanted to come out, but then Javed, me and Dad said that, you know, you've been challenged and, you know, you shouldn't take the field until you get an apology from the England captain. And of course, by the time all of this came out, we lost half a day.
Pakistan team management was, in fact, pretty sure that the mistake was committed by Mike Gatting and not by shakoor rana, and he was the one who instigated it, and so he should apologize. And then obviously Mike Gatting said, nothing doing, I was in my right really to protest. And it was in fact shakoor rana with that finger pointing at me was a little out of order. So yes, I mean, I know for a fact that Pakistan management was pretty keen for an apology.
Negotiations began between Pakistan Board Secretary Ijaz Butt, England team manager Peter Lush, and England coach Mickey Stewart to see if the game could be restarted.
Gat was under considerable duress. The Test and County Cricket Board had been meeting in London while the diplomatic impasse was not being resolved in Pakistan. And the message was that the tour and the game had to go on. And therefore, England's captain had to do whatever the Pakistan authorities wanted him to do to make sure that the appearances were maintained.
Eventually, Gat did send a note through to apologise into the umpire. And Javed, me and Dad were sort of stirring up again in the background with him saying, oh, it's Your Honour, and Your Honour is being challenged, and etc., etc. And of course, we didn't go on field that day.
They've both been in the room together this morning, and that was the sole purpose of getting an agreement. You think that would be possible, but shakoor rana wouldn't accept it.
What was the atmosphere like?
Well, a little bit tense, really, in the situation. The umpire is very sensitive.
I'm 100% correct, 100% confident.
Well, one would hope for the good of the game, which is, after all, much more important than anything else, that he would accept Mike Gatting's apology, provide his own, and get on with the job.
The game was eventually restarted, but too late to force a result.
What we did try to do and negotiate was to, rather than have a rest day, because we lost a day, is not have a rest day and make up the time. But they were adamant they didn't want to do that. They just wanted to play the actual hours or the days that were scheduled for the game. And we did. And we spent various times during that match with coming off a bad light, which really wasn't bad light.
It just got blown out of all proportion. The only thing I can say, we just felt there's 15 or 16 English cricketers, and we just felt, well, that was it, us against the whole of Pakistan and the whole of the world. Wrongly. You know, we had team meeting after team meeting, and some of the younger guys who had not been, hadn't seen this sort of, bear in mind, I'd been to Pakistan already, knew what could happen. You know, some of them were just saying, right, let's pack our bags and go home. One or two of the older guys, I remember John Embry saying, you know, we've got to think a bit deeper and a bit more carefully about this.
We had a meeting and we had a vote on it, and I think that of the 16 players, it was something like an 11-5 vote that we go home. I wasn't comfortable with the decision that was made. I just felt that the young players had got railroaded into something that they didn't really want to be part of. And the following day we had another vote, and it actually got turned around sort of 10-6, 9-7, the other way that we stay. So it's when you have a little bit more time to think about it and you reflect on things, which the players did, they realised that perhaps leaving and going home and not finishing the tour was the wrong thing to do. So we continued on. and finish a tour.
I suppose what you can say is that we end up with neutral umpires, which might have helped, and I have to say Imran Khan was certainly very much for neutral umpires. And I suppose that's where it's got us, and people might say that might have been the good that came out of it.
It was a series that cast a shadow over the game, and it would take a further 7 years until the ICC ruled that at least one neutral umpire would stand in Test cricket. This ruling was reformed in 2002, stating that both umpires must be independent of the competing nations. For the record, Pakistan won the three-match series 1-0.